back to another episode of Backpack Bushcraft. It is Friday, and we are doing another How It's Crafted. Now, this item is very important to me. It's actually an item that I created basically all by myself. I've never seen an item quite like this, and a lot of people have asked me questions about this. So today, without any further ado, we're going to be working on my paracord belt. So how this idea came about was due to three factors. The first factor was I watched a couple videos by David Carberry. The first one being a video on the Watery Belt, the importance of it in the frontier, its historical significance, and also just how it works in modern times as a tool belt. And I really like the thing. I actually have one. I've shown it before. And it works really well, especially for a big guy like me who it's hard to find very large belts that fit real well. The Watery Belt was a perfect solution because it fits almost any size as long as it's big enough. And even if you are very tiny and you use the Watery Belt, you can still use it. You just have a lot of extra slack. To me, that's not a big deal. And I absolutely love my Watery Belt. The second factor was I watched another video by David Carberry during his Diary of the TB series where he figure wove a strap for his quiver. Now, this was very important because that was my introduction to figure weaving. And without that step, none of this would have ever came about. But I watched him, learned a lot of stuff. That the final factor was my friend came over wearing a braided belt and he was showing it off to me. And I said, you know, if somebody took a braided belt and replaced the braids of the braided belt with paracord, you have a paracord belt that you could use in survival. Also, so the first step, you're going to need two different colors of paracord. Right here, I just have a black and I have a OD green over there. That's typically the ones I use. But you can use any colors at all. I would recommend you starting off with two. It's very easy to learn this finger pattern, but once you have it mastered, you can really do it however you want. The first thing you have to do is unwind all this paracord because you're going to need to cut it down to size. Now, typically these hanks of paracord come in 50-foot sections, and what I'm going to be doing is taking each of these 50-foot sections, cutting it into basically a fourth of itself. Divide it into half, cut that, and then we'll take the two half pieces and divide that and cut that in half. So I'll end up with four sections of 12 and a half. I'll then be doing a lark's head knot onto this ring. You can get these in where you find chains and other stuff like that at a hardware store. I can actually get this at Walmart for very cheap. And I want to put six to five different lark's heads. I will show you how to do all that here in a minute. Okay, so after you have your section, what you want to do is you want to fold it in half. That takes your 12 and a half foot section, or that's what I'm using, and tucks it into 6 1/4. And you just want to put a lark's head onto this, all right? And just leave the outside through. Try to real quick. I'll show you how to do that. So now how I do that is I take the two ends here, hold them in one hand, slowly pull all the way to my loop here. Want to be very careful because I don't want to pull too much in one way or it'll throw it off. It won't be even. And I want to get this as even as possible. Alright. Try to make sure your knot's going the same way. And then after that, you want to check your work. These should come up just about the same. It's a little off. I'm okay with that because I can trim that up at the end anyway. I'll probably have to anyway. All right, there's two. Now, again, these ends are not the prettiest, but that's fine. We'll trim it up at the end. Now we begin finger weaving. Now, when you want to do this, you want to make sure all your knots are uniform. You want to make sure everything looks pretty. And you just want to start by crossing over the top. It's the easiest way I do it. Cross over the top. Go under the next one. Go over. Go under. Go over. Go under. Go over. Go under. Go over. Pull it tight. Pull it off to the side. I actually have another door here, as you can see. And I just wrap it around the handle just so it's out of my way. And then I move on to the next one. I go over and under. Right here, you'll be able to tell what you need to do. If you went over up here, you're going to go under here. And over, under. Make sure your line stays kind of tight and organized, because this was where you will start to make mistakes. Under. And then we're gonna go over here, under here. That last one, you wanna make sure you have him at the top and just cross it, just like you would the others. Kind of look at your work, make sure it looks right. Give it a little pull, make some top. Pull that off, there you go. So this is it completely done. As you can see, it's just simple hand woven through here. The very thin belt, my other ones are just a little bit thicker, but like again, this is gonna go through my belt loop. Now here's the end. What I do is the last little bit I have left, I will weave it all the way through, wrap it around and tie it, and I'll just do it. That sort of decreases the amount and you get this sort of looks like a snake tail pattern. Actually, I'll show you a little bit more when I get to this end. You can leave them long, but it makes it look real nasty. So I do recommend cut them off and re-burn them and dress it up. Maybe leave just a little bit in case you have to retie. I've had to do that a couple times. But that's basically it. Let me finish this up and I'll show you the finished product. Well, guys, that'll do it for this week. The Rattlesnake Paracord Belt by Bushy on the Backpack Bushcraft online store. This will set you back about $15 to $20, somewhere in that price range. We're still trying to narrow it down. This will be at festivals, and I do promise to sell this on the website, absolutely. Also, when I hit my 250 sub, which I'm literally one sub away, when I hit 250, I want to do my giveaway. I want to give away one of these belts, but it's going to be a lot more customizable for the individual. So, if you want that to happen, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel, Backpack Bushcraft. You can also follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Gmail at Backpack Bushcraft. You can also check out the website where I post content on Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays, 2 p.m. EST. That website is www.backpackbushcraft.com. And until next time, guys, keep those fires burning. You put in the long run for me.